Hello guys, today we're going to be talking about the Corkscrew model. This is a coaster model that is cloned at many parks, meaning that it is the same coaster model, it is just remade and then rebuilt and then put at multiple coaster parks at the same time. It features three inversions, which we'll talk about today. So let's get started. We're going to go through the coaster, a little tour of the coaster, by going through it once, and then we'll go through the elements, we'll go through it again, and then we'll talk about some dimensions and stuff. So let's begin. Dip into the station, lift hill. As you can see, this lift hill is larger than the other two we've done. And then we got a vertical loop up into a hill. And we have a little curve. A wonky set of curving into the first corkscrew, down into the next corkscrew, and then a long ride back to the station. As you can see, this is why this model is called a corkscrew, because it focuses on, well, the corkscrew inversion. But we'll get to those later. I just want to quickly go over the basics real quick. So as you saw, we had a little break there. Four to three power rails, operated with a button to get the coaster to the lift hill. Signature drop we saw in the Mine Train coaster. The wooden coaster is probably the only coaster on here, on this series, that will have that no little drop before the lift hill. Then we got a lift hill, a basic chain lift, lift hill replication. Remember, we put a power rail, three blocks, power rail, three blocks, power rail, three blocks, power rail, three blocks, power rail at the top, and down to the drop. The support structure, you don't have to replicate it, you can make it your own. I just try to make it more or less similar to the support structure used in the real life coaster, which is Corkscrew at Cedar Point. I will be posting that down in the description so you can look it up later, maybe watch the POV and see how similar it is. But this is how the support structure looks on the coaster. The coaster is from the 70s, so we're still looking at an old coaster. We won't see anything from the 2010s or modern era until we get to the next coaster, which is that one. But yeah, basic chain lift hill down into the first inversion we are talking about. And this looks very different from the one over there, but somewhat similar. It doesn't go on top of the loop, it goes around the loop structure. I'm going to, for future coasters, we're going to be using the structure we talked about in the inversions video, but for this coaster, this was made before the inversion video was talked about, so I used a more primitive loop, but you know, it's from the 1970s, they built this in the 1970s, man, they didn't have all this looping technology figured out. But yeah, it's the basic still idea of a vertical loop. You go up, around, and then back the same direction. You go up an airtime hill. Now this one is much bigger than the ones over there and on the mine train. So, but still basic design, flat three blocks, up and down. Up into a little curve here. Still the same primitive support structure as before. Little turn. Then we got a wonky set of little turns here. I would just avoid ever making a turn like this. This is just how it looks on the coaster, which is why I did it. But this coaster, this turn right here is horrifically bad. This looks ugly as heck. This looks ugly as heck. So I would just make a turn like that, just a general turn. Into the first corkscrew. We have a corkscrew element. We have two of them. Red, white, and blue. Sorry, tripped on my tongue. Red, white, and blue. The colors of America. You can color them however you want. Like the ones we did in the inversion video, as you can see, it's just blue and white. But you can add a little. I added another layer of red in between, just, you know, to make it blue, white, red. Or red, white, and blue. As you can see, it's a basic corkscrew element. We talked about in the inversions video, if you want to go back and see how to make those, but it's just a general corkscrew element. It is off the ground a little bit. It is two blocks off the ground. but it is held together by the support structures on either side. So you can make it look like, you can add a little support block right there if you want to make it look better, but it is really held up by the two support beams there and there, so no need. But if you think it looks ugly, then you can add a support beam at the bottom, no problem. And then it goes from this corkscrew right into another one. And the general gist, and then as you can see, this just goes right back to the station. You can add a little bit of hills here if you want to. I didn't because the coaster doesn't have this. As you can probably guess, they didn't really care if you went how the ride was after these two corkscrews, because these two corkscrews are right over where people are walking. Like, people will be walking right next to these as people will be going through them. So the ride was really based on these two corkscrews, which is why they are like right there, like in a diagonal. They look really cool in real life, and you can see people, like, you can see people going right above your head, right above your head as you're walking through them. So it's really cool, and it is the ride's main gimmick. They also had a vertical loop, which is pretty cool, and an airtime hill, but the main thing with these two corkscrews, this model's pretty basic. I mean, we'll be talking about the other ones later, but this one is pretty one note when it comes to inversions. I already did the roller coaster inversions, so if you want to know how to make a vertical loop or how to make corkscrew, in this case you need two corkscrews. Corkscrews, you just take the exit of one corkscrew and link it up with a couple blocks in between to the entrance of the next corkscrew, down into a little drop here from that exit of the second corkscrew, and then you just make a path to the station. Again, you don't have to do it this bland. It is a very bland course back to the station. You can add some hills here if you want to. But yeah, that's a pretty big overview. I'm gonna go through it again, and now that you know about the elements, I can point them out more loosely, and then we can go into some dimensions if you want to replicate this at your own Minecraft theme park. Remember, multiple parks use this. I'm only using Corkscrew at Cedar Point as a reference, just for the color scheme. These coasters can be found in, I think, like three other parks, and they're usually smaller, and then they're also found, there's also another version of this that doesn't have the vertical loop, just the two corkscrews, that is just an airtime hill with two corkscrews. So let's begin. Drop, lift hill, big lift hill. This is 33 blocks tall, by the way, just in future reference. Vertical loop, airtime hill, curve around, wonky little turns here. As you can see, these are very bumpy. Corkscrew, turn into the next corkscrew, then drop, and then ride back to the station. So yeah, that's the corkscrew coaster. I'll go into some dimensions in a little bit, and then we'll wrap up. So the lift hill is 33 blocks tall. The structures are on a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, so an 8. So you build up 8 blocks, then go across 8, then you build another column that's 8, then 8 again, then make another cross, and then up to the top. So that structure works. Same over here, just build up 8, cross, then make another pike. The vertical loop is, it is 3 blocks off the ground. The structure itself, right there, is 4 blocks off the ground. The structure is 3, 1, 4, 1, 3, 1, 4, 1. And then you just make a little turnaround structure around the loop. I would actually, if you're making this coaster after this video, I'd just make a vertical loop like the one over there from the inversions video, so it doesn't look this wonky and weird. But yeah, then we go into the next hill, same support structure, 8, go across 8, and this hill is 3, 6, 9, 12, 6, 15, 16. So this is 16. This is half as tall as the one over there. So this is 16 blocks tall, goes down. This turnaround here is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. This is 8 blocks tall, goes down. This series of turns, I would just make this a corner again, like that one over there, into the first corkscrew. This corkscrew's dimensions are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so 7, 1, 1, and then 5, 1, 1, 1, 7. Oh, that's weird. So you got 7 up here, then 1, 1, 5, 1, 1, 1, 5, 1, 1, 1, 5, 1, 1, 7. Same for the one over here. And then this little pathway here is just 4 blocks tall, all the way back to the station. It goes down 1 here, just to make it have more speed. This is 3 blocks tall, all the way back to the 3 block tall station. And a little brake block here so the train stops. So we're going to do one more lap around where it's a silent POV, and then we'll end the video. So yeah, that is the corkscrew looping coaster, a 3 inversion vertical loop to corkscrew coaster with an airtime hill and a little turnaround curve area and then back to the station. Very plain and simple. So I would say that these three coasters are very simple. You've got simple inverting coaster, you've got a little simple wooden coaster, and a simple mine train coaster that's more for scenic routes. Next video, we get into the big deals. These are the big coasters. These are the coasters that are the biggest baddie ones. These are the ones that have elements that are big, large, and insane. We'll be talking about this one. Next video, we'll get into this one. Then we'll just be going in alphabetical order all around. We'll get to that one eventually. That's 420 feet tall. 420. You know what the deal is. And then we get into the big, then we get also into this one. Not as tall as that one, that's taller than this one, but this is 400 feet. This is 300 feet tall over here with those mega structures. Anyway guys, that'll do it for this video. Hope you guys like the video, and like if you like, dislike if you don't, subscribe if you really like it, and I'll see you guys next time. Toodaloo.